everybody. Welcome to the Actors Academy. Thank you for tuning in today. In today's video, we're going to be talking about 10 acting secrets. And these may be points that you've never heard before, or maybe you've heard some of them. Maybe you're an advanced actor, you're an intermediate actor, or maybe you're just starting out and you're at the beginning. Whatever stage you're in, these 10 points will be helpful for you to know as an actor. Now, before we get into this video, do make sure that you guys give this video a thumbs up. It does help the channel out and it's super quick. Just go down below and hit that thumbs up there and leave any comments that you have after this video down in the description below. Now, without further ado, let's get into it. So point number one, I get a lot of actors messaging me telling me that they go and do their self-tape submissions, or maybe they've had the opportunity to record a student film and they've been on camera and they've seen themselves. And the one complaint that I get from them is that their faces doesn't always look like they have a lot of emotion in them. Maybe when they're talking and they're speaking, the emotion's there and it's present. But then when the other actor starts speaking, and maybe you've fallen into this trap before, all of a sudden your face doesn't look like it has any emotion left, there's nothing going on, and you're thinking to yourself, oh my god, what am I doing wrong? When I speak, I'm great. When I don't speak, I suck. Here is a trick that you can use. I got this from one of my instructors who had gone to Juilliard before, and he said, this is something you can use. When you're looking at the other person, this is what I want you guys to do. Even though you're not actually speaking any lines or saying anything, your character is feeling something. Now, however they are feeling, you are going to talk to that person, but in your head. So let's say, for example, there's this person that you hate. You're not going to say to yourself, I hate this person. You're going to imagine as if you were telling the person in front of you, I hate you, but without actually speaking. It's all going to be in your head. Or let's imagine it's something a little bit more positive, and this is someone that you love. Well, in your head, you're going to say, I love you. Even though your mouth is not moving, you're not speaking, when the person is talking to you, in order to have some life in your eyes, in your face, in your body, in your head, say the lines, I love you, how you're feeling, or if you hate someone, I hate you, or if you're mad at somebody, I'm so mad at you, or if you're excited to see somebody, or if you're happy. You have these things going on in your head where you're actually saying how you're feeling. You're not turning it into 5, 10, 15 sentences. All you're doing is very shortly, just in your head, saying how you feel. I hate you. I love you. I'm mad at you. I'm so happy you're here. Whatever it is, but you're saying it in your head. Point number two is to realize that actors are not always crying real tears. Yeah, believe it or not, anytime you see an actor cry on the screen or on TV, sometimes you may be thinking, oh my gosh, these people have so much talent to be able to go and cry on cue like that. Well, sometimes we don't have the ability to cry all that well. Maybe it's something within the day, or something's going on, or maybe someone just doesn't have that talent to cry on cue. Is it something that you can learn and develop? Yes, it is. Does it sometimes come organically and naturally? Yes, it does. We've also talked many times on this channel before about how to go and cry on cue. But sometimes you just can't do it and it's not working. When you're on set, if the director really wants you to cry in the scene, then you have to have tears come out and it just isn't happening naturally, or for whatever reason you're not able to make the tears come by yourself, what they'll use is they'll have this thing called a crying stick. I'm going to link down actually a video below where this actress talks about it. I'm James Corden. You guys can check it out. That'll be down in the description below, but make sure you guys finish this video first before you guys go and check that one out. Point number three is confidence. So a lot of actors tell me, how do I get good? How do I up my chances at booking a part? How in the world can I go and become a stronger, better actor? How do I boost my opportunities of potentially getting booked? And I will always tell this to actors, and it depends who's gonna listen. You can tell somebody something, but it doesn't actually mean they're gonna listen or they're gonna try and improve or develop that skill. But it really comes down to confidence. Confidence is a huge thing within this industry. Just look at how many actors are out there who aren't always the best actors in the world. You do not have to be the best actor to get booked on a job. Sometimes you have to be the actor that, yes, fits the part, but also you gotta have a personality that the casting director likes, that the directors like, that the producers like. Sometimes a part could be lost to somebody else because they just like that person more. If it's between you and another person and they just have a better rapport with this person, either of you could play this character, but they just like person B more than person A, well, they're gonna go with person B, whoever they like more. When you have confidence, you're able to bring your true self out. When we don't have confidence and we have fear or nervous, we have this veil that comes up, and then we start to put on a persona. It's kind of like when you have a crush in real life, and when you go and talk to your best friend, you're yourself, you're you, who you actually are. But then when you go and talk to your crush, all of a sudden you're not fully yourself. There's a little bit of a wall that comes up. You're trying to be cool or you're trying to be funny instead of just actually being yourself. The same applies in the audition setting where they just want to see you. They don't want you to try to act or try to seem like, you know, you're right for the part. They just want you to be who you are. Tip number four is simply just being a more well-rounded person. The more well-rounded that you are, the more that you can naturally bring to a character or bring to a conversation when you are having that one-on-one with the director or the casting director or the producers. There is no way in the world that anyone has ever said being a more well-rounded person hinders you. It actually helps you a lot. So the more that you can learn, the more that you can read, watch documentaries, watch old films, keep learning, keep developing, become a more well-rounded person. Tip number five is to practice. Practice, practice, practice. Actors all the time will try and work in some sort of way. Maybe they're taking acting classes. Maybe they're trying to create their own theater company. Maybe they're participating in plays, or they're going and auditioning for student films, or they're actually getting booked in projects. Whatever it is, a good actor will always try and work, always try and act in some capacity, in some sort of way. We talked about on this channel before, maybe you don't have the opportunity to go and be in a play or start your own company or go and be in a short film or a movie. You don't have the opportunity to even audition or try for these projects. Well, we've talked about on this channel ways to go and just practice your acting from home. If you're interested in that, I'll leave a link right up here for how you can go and practice your acting at home. There's a whole playlist that we made on it. Or if you're really serious about acting and you really want to go and develop your craft and push it forward and find ways of how you can actually work and practice your craft of acting, not just in the short term, but in the long term, then you can always check out our 10-hour Acting Masterclass 2.0, which we always leave down in the description down below or in the comment section if you're interested in that. Point number six is a little bit of a new one, but it actually is very important for you guys to know in this time and in this day of age that we're in. A lot of auditions have become online. I mean, you can submit for auditions online and even sometimes book these auditions online in the Zoom platform. Since the logistics, as everybody knows, has been messed up for movie productions and movie sets, a lot of people are trying to create their own projects just on Zoom itself. Are these projects amazing and great compared to if you booked a big Marvel movie or something on ABC or something like that? No, of course not. But if you're actually wanting to just grow your resume, let's say you have nothing on it right now, now is one of the easiest times that you can do this. I made a video talking about this before. If you guys want to check it out, I'll leave it right up here. Go and click on that and you go straight to that video. Point number seven is having good representation helps you more than you know. Some people could have an agent or a manager that they have them on their client list, but they never submit them for projects. They're never actually trying to help them book a part. Compared to if you have somebody who's in your corner, who's working for you, submitting you all the time for projects, trying to get you booked, that person is helping you. You want to have good representation in your corner. Just as you want to do a lot of good work for them, you want them to also do a lot of good work for you. Point number eight is to take your time when you're doing a monologue or you're doing a scene and you're on camera and you're being filmed. Take your time. Don't rush it. A lot of actors think, okay, I got this whole monologue memorized in my head. Let me go and just speak these lines and speed through it. Even though you may not purposely be trying to do this, naturally it tends to happen more often than not. Remember, take your time, take your pauses, it will help you more than you know. If you guys want more details on this, I'll link another video that I did right up here. You can go and click on that and you'll get a lot more details into this idea of pausing, taking your time, taking those beats. Point number nine is having good headshots. Have a great photo of you. Even if your acting is great, but your headshot sucks, it's gonna be very hard for you to ever get into a room. Because when a casting director is casting for a part and they're looking for either the bad boy type of character or the boy next door, or the girl next door, whatever character that they're actually looking for, they see your headshot first. It's a picture of you so they can see, hey, does this person look like they would fit potentially this bad boy character or potentially the boy next door? If yes, then they'll bring you in. If no, that's already a way for them to eliminate you and say, okay, we don't need to bring this person in for this role. Let's bring other actors in. If you want an opportunity to get into that room, you have to have a good, solid headshot. And the last point here is to enjoy the process. So as an actor, you're gonna have to be practicing a lot. You're gonna have to go on a lot of different auditions. If you get lucky enough and you're on set or you're part of a project, there's gonna be a lot of work involved. You, for yourself, have to be able to enjoy this process, and you have to figure out ways of how you can do that. Every single person is different, so the way that you enjoy a project may be different than the way I enjoy a project. Some things that can help you though, especially in the auditioning process, because most actors, when you're starting out and you're auditioning, you're gonna have a lot of auditions that you go for that you're not gonna book. That's just the nature of this industry. And for a lot of people, they can get beaten down and they get too tired of it and then they quit acting altogether because it's just not fun anymore. Sometimes the best thing that you can do, when you have a lot of hard work that you have to go and get done, you're preparing for this character, you go for an audition, and then your audition's done, have something fun that you like to do after. It just keeps your positivity up. It can help you enjoy the process a little bit more because you have something to look forward to after the work that you've done. And then of course, if you get lucky enough and then you book, then boom, you're on cloud nine and you're doing great. But in the meantime, try to have ways where you can enjoy this process, whether it's you actually enjoy doing something in the middle of the work, or it's after you've done your job and you've completed your auditions that you plan something to do afterwards that you enjoy that keeps your positivity up. So I hope you guys like this video. These are 10 points that are very, very important for the actor. Again, it doesn't matter if you're just starting out, if you're intermediate, or you're advanced. These points are important for everybody to know. So make sure you guys subscribe to the channel so you stay up to date with everything. Give this video a thumbs up if it helped you guys. Also, I'll be leaving our 10-hour Acting Masterclass 2.0 down in the description down below and also in the comment section if you're interested in that, as well as our 10 acting resume templates. Alrighty, thanks guys.